So, in this part of our lecture, we are going to study about the types, care and safety aspects of centrifuges. And here the remaining type which have been taught, other than that we are going to discuss, other than care, maintenance and safety aspects. So, other than low speed centrifuge and microfuge, there is one called as high speed refrigerator centrifuges. And it is essential for the sedimentation of protein precipitates, large intact cell organelles and cellular debris. Now it is obtained from tissue homogenization and from microorganisms. We can obtain from these sources. So the initial bulk separation of cellular elements prior to preparative ultracentrifugation, which is very high in nature, and it is what we can say before proceeding to that centrifugation, ultracentrifugation, we can do this thing, and it is operated maximum something like 100,000 RCF or 100,000 Qi. And it is not sufficient to sediment smaller microsomal vesicles or ribosomes. So it can be employed to differentially separate nuclei, mitochondria or chloroplast. For bulk protein aggregates can be sedimented, and contractile apparatus from muscle fibers by homogenization consisting of myosin and actin. We have seen this example in the separation of in subcellular fractionation of muscle tissues. Now it is also used to harvest yeast cell or bacteria from large volumes of culture media. Now it is used in a continuous flow mode with zonal rotors, which actually is an industrial application, and centrifuge tubes are not used, and it is used as a continuous flow of medium, and particles are sedimented against the rotor periphery, and excess liquid removed through a special outlet. So it is a special type of centrifuge which is having a continuous flow mode, where the continuous inlet of media can be applied. Next part, the final part of the types of centrifuges, is called as ultracentrifuge, or the process ultracentrifugation, and used for the detailed biochemical analysis of subcellular structures, isolated biomolecules. And now the preparative one can be operated something up to 900,000 or 9 lakh RCF or 9 lakh G. Now, to reduce air friction, the rotor chamber is sealed, evacuated and refrigerated. So the sealing is required for proper evacuation. It also helps in the refrigeration. Now we have already discussed that this sealing or vacuum is important to maintain the lesser amount of air friction, because there's a chance of generation of heat with the presence of air inside the chamber. Now, depending on the type, age and condition, and cooling and stable vacuum takes large operational time, because first of all, if some centrifuge is something like old model or old age or old centrifuge, it may take some time to get proper evacuation and proper cooling. So overall, the long operational time will be required. So what we do, we actually switch on at least. So what is the usual procedure? So because of the longer operational time, we usually switch on it at least 1 hour prior to the process of centrifugation. And right now the current devices, the modern ultracentrifuges, are automated and advantageous. So what we can do, it actually what we can say take less time. Now safety aspect for the ultracentrifugation, it is having a heavy armor plating to prevent injury. It's a metal plating which actually cannot be broken even if there is something like a failure of the device. So second thing is, it cannot be initiated without proper closing of the chamber system. So if you want to start it, at least require to the proper closing of the chamber system. Other is, temperature regulation system is very fine. There is a flexible drive shaft. So suppose if there is any type of imbalance, in spite of breaking, it can be bend. So that is why this axis or shaft is quite helpful in preventing the any type of accident. And there is an over speed control device. If the device is going over speed or intentionally operated, unintentionally operated, anything which is being done, so it can control this. Automated switch off of misbalancing of tubes, that is very particular feature that can be attached with the ultracentrifuge. And this type of device is required for swinging bucket rotor, because in swinging bucket rotor, even at lower RPM, because of higher Rmax, usually more RCF can be achieved. So this device is, this type of switching system is, switching off system is quite helpful for this ultracentrifugation where the swinging bucket rotors are being used. Now we have talked about the application, few things, just like it is containing a solid rotor, an analytical cell and counterbalancing cell. We have discussed about this device already, and it's having an optical system and enables the sedimenting material to be observed throughout the centrifugation. And it using a light absorption system, it's called as Schillerin system or relay system, it can be used. And both of the optical system are actually change detect the change in the refractive index of the solution caused by the concentration changes. So basically other one system can be used to monitor the refractive index, and this refractive index can be used to calculate the absorbance and all these changes. So we have talked about the application, determination of molecular mass and isolated macromolecule, thermodynamic property of a protein or other large biomolecules. So these things can be studied here. Now the final part which we can understand here, the care and maintenance of the centrifuge. So first thing is the corrosion and degradation. So because of the corrosion and interior or exterior, their spillage may be there and it can affect the lifetime of equipment. So it should be avoided. So proper balancing of the tubes is required. There should be, there may be vibration induced damage to rotor and drive shafts. So it should be avoided with the balancing. And cleaning, any type of liquid that may be any acidic and basic in nature. So there is actually a proper paint. So it's like a polyurethane paint or aluminium oxide is there. So for washing, we should not be using any type of hard brushes, and non-corrosive detergent should be used. Finally, there may be alkaline solution or acidic buffer or aggressive detergent or salt that may cause some corrosion. So we should be avoiding this thing, or if it is in contact, we should be immediately removing that. And it should be washed with a distilled or deionized water after every run. And usually it is first lift upside down to drain the excess liquid. It should be reversed, and it should be positioned in a safe and dry place. There should be further no humidity in that place. Now for drying of swinging bucket rotor, it should be removal of buffer, drying with the tissue paper and washing with the water. And always when we take care of this thing, there should be a avoiding the destruction of protective coating layers. Rotor coating should be avoided. If you want to know, the handling of the rotor should be kept in a special clean room or space, and pre-cooling of the rotor prior to centrifugation is a suggestive technique, suggestive idea. And it should be avoided for putting it in long-term storage in a wet and cold environment. So a person should be there, or personally researcher should be observing all these things. And if you talk about the maintenance, regular maintenance of rotor and centrifuges by engineers. So usually there is a warranty period where engineers can give free services, other than it should be done with qualified persons. And there should be a proper bookkeeping for the replacement of rotor or parts of centrifuge. So record should be maintained. And there is one thing, there is a phenomena called as a metal fatigue, where there is a cyclic acceleration or deacceleration, it may cause to metal fatigue. So there should be change in the rotors for avoiding that thing. Safety aspect, if you talk about, so rotor chambers of high speed and ultracentrifuges are enclosed in heavy armor plating. So if there is any type of mishap, so it should be avoided, that no person damage should be there. Automatic switching off mode while imbalance, helpful for tube cracking and during centrifugation, because of the chance of drainage of water, drainage of the buffer when there's a tube cracking. So there should be automatic switch off mode. and correct distribution of load is very important with partially loading or order of tube must be organized. Because suppose if you are having something like what tube you are having 10 ml, 5 ml and 3 ml, and we should be using it this in duplets, duplicates. So 3 ml tube should be counterbalancing, 5 ml should to be counterbalancing, 10 ml should to be counterbalancing, something like that. Fixing the rotor is important for ultra centrifugation and both for small and large capacity bench centrifuges. Swinging bucket rotor balancing is important. Load buckets with caps properly screwed on, and if only two tubes are loaded with solution, empty swinging bucket also have to be assembled, because these devices are not made to run in isolation. So suppose there are four or six buckets there, and if you are only using two plates, it doesn't mean that you need to remove remaining. What happens, individual rotor buckets are numbered, so usually they should not be interchanged between their designated position. So if one bucket is supposed to kept at position one, so it should be marked and it should be kept at that particular place. If you talk about the acceleration regarding the swing bucket rotor, low acceleration and deceleration rate should be there to avoid the disturbance of gradient and risk of distribution bucket attachment and occurrence of sudden imbalance due to deformation or cracking. So it should be always a low acceleration or deceleration there. And every person should be aware of exposure. So potentially harmful substances, chemicals, dangerous chemicals, infected materials or radioactive substances, these should be avoided, or there should be proper knowledge of these substances if anyone is in using these things. And up-to-date safety manual should be there, and safety statements of individual departments should be mentioned very there. Now, another thing is called as mock run, or avoid any loss of precious specimen or expensive chemicals. So experiment should not be do very in a first place. So there should be a mock run, and protective clothing should be worn all the times. Handling of tubes are important. Slow and carefully should be handled, not to disrupt the pellet bands or unstable gradients in case of density gradient centrifugation. And manufacturers usually provide details for the right kind of centrifuge tube for a particular application, so you should be following that thing. Now there are a few factors considered for tubes. Chemically resistant to solvent used, have the right capacity for sample loading, can be used in the designated rotors, and able to withstand the maximum centrifugal force and temperature ranges. So these things should be very clear for the tubes before the use. Thick walled or fixed angle rotor, high RCF can cause a collapse. So this is thing, the volume of liquid and sealing mechanisms, and it should be follow manufacturer instructions. Swinging bucket rotor tubes are better protector for deformation, and usually thin walled polyaluminum tubes are used for swinging bucket. It should not be putting excessive load because of just tubes. And puncturing and slicing of tubes should be there. So post centrifugation analysis, piercing from the bottom, and slicing after quick freezing. Both techniques can be used for that. And there is one precaution, using radioliable and toxic substances, and avoid contamination of centrifugation chamber and rotor cavities or bucket should be. From these substances, these should not be touching. And if suppose we are using toxic substances or radioliable substances routinely, so we should be dedicating a particular centrifuge and accompanying rotor for that purpose only. So these are certain instructions.